Stop messing us about!
Just give it up, Terry.
Come on, Terry, this is your last chance!
There's no use in hiding.
Don't be a silly boy, Terry!
Come down here now and open this door.
Come on, Terry, last chance saloon for you!
Come on, boss, just leave it, isn't it?
Last chance!
It's not worth it, Gov, it's not worth it.
Well, isn't it a man's right to have a battered sausage? No. Well, isn't it?
There's one down the road, we'll just try there.
Oh, yeah, yeah, they're doing mean curry sauce. No more. No bleeding more. I've had it up to here with it, Doyle.
It's diarrhoea back again, is it, sir?
No, it bleeding well isn't, Doyle. If you must know, I'm shitting bricks on the hour. Nice and solid, like nature intended it. None of that namby-pamby runny stuff that looks like last night's curry.
All right, sir, I think you get the picture.
Well, picture this then, Doyle. Two loyal and highly trained committed officers of the law sat in a car waiting for some scum to come around. Just some ordinary drug dealer. When we could be out there on the mean streets of Exeter fighting the real scumbags. And that's just the bleeding students.
They ain't all that bad, sir. Come on.
They ain't all that bad, Doyle. All they do is loiter up the streets, drinking fancy coffee and wearing berets, saying they're corrected.
Sure you're not thinking about the French?
Oh, don't get me bleeding started on them. They're just a bunch of garlic-stinking, frog-eating fairies with too much bloody time on their hands. All they do is sit around grooming their hair and wearing poncy vests, looking slimier than an owl. That's just the bleeding blokes.
Yeah, but the women?
Oh, Doyle, the women don't do it for me. It's just too much oohing and aahing and bonjouring. I can't be putting up with that. If you're gonna be talking to me, speak English, speak proper English. Right, Doyle, we've got scumbags over here, yeah?
Yeah.
But at least you understand what the bleeding hell they're saying, unlike the French. Where is this wheeler, dealer, druggy, muggy prat?
It's still pretty early, Gov. He's probably having a lie-in.
It's all right for some, innit? Us, loyal, tax-paying citizens, have got to wait here, get up early in the morning to wait here to watch Jason flipping grand, a drug dealer who gets to have a nice, cosy lie-in. It's unbelievable. It really is.
Just think about it. If we catch him on the act today, on the camera, he'll be looking at a long stretch inside.
That's if we bleeding well catch him, Doyle. Four times I've nicked him. Four bleeding times. And every time, some prat in a little wig's banged his hammer, said no evidence. No solid bleeding evidence.
Well, that's why we're here today, yeah?
Well, just remember one thing, Doyle. My arse is on the line and I don't want to cock up. How long is this bloody gonna take? I am starving.
Starving? You had a curry an hour ago and it's 11 o'clock in the morning.
I know, but that was last night's leftovers. And plus, you nicked my naan bread, you greedy git! I feel cheated, to be honest with you.
What, about the naan bread?
No, not about that, oh. You prat. About this. Ross came up to me. She said, how do you fancy a steak out? I thought, great! I ain't had steak and chips for months. How was I blimmy meant to know? It meant sitting in a bloody car with nothing to do, watching scum getting ready to do a bloody drugs deal.
Do you want me to pop to the shops and get you a mid-morning snack, sir? You're getting a bit cranky.
Yeah, yeah. It's about time you did something useful, Doyle. And if there's a queue, flash your warrant card. Say it's urgent police business.
What do you want, then?
Not much, Doyle, not much. Just a Snickers bar.
Okay.
Oh yeah, get a Mars bar and a Fanta.
Is that it?
No, get a bacon buddy as well.
All right, back in a minute.
Doyle! Get a jam donut! Make sure it's got extra jam! Oh, that is lovely. Nice and refreshing. Can't really hit the spot, Doyle.
What about a game of I Spy?
I Pissing Spy? Yeah. You must be joking.
I Spy My Little Eye, something beginning with T.
Oh, come on, Doyle, that's too easy. Gander's at this. book.
What are you reading?
Something actually quite profound and intelligent. You wouldn't get it.
By that, I would have thought you meant Shakespeare or something, not Nuts magazine.
Doyle, Doyle, Doyle. It's pretty much the same thing. Give or take a few topless birds on the front. I mean, if they had topless birds on the front of Romeo and Piss and Juliet, I would have loved English. But I'll tell you something, Dom. You have underestimated the power of Nuts magazine. This magazine is full of facts and intrigue, okay? Take this for example. Did you know the leatherback turtle weighs over 350 kilograms? Huh? It's all here in the pub ammo. Laser guided facts for going down the boozer.
Yep, you learn something new every day.
Whoa, look at the size of those.
Yeah, you can rent them out at children's parties, saving you having to fork out a bouncy castle.
Have a swig of this. Bloody boiling, isn't it, Doyle? Yeah. What about a game of cards, eh?
Yeah, right, you're on.
Let's see if they're in it. Not a cracking pair!